Another day, another start, people. How are you all? I hope everyone is very good at home. And those who are coming and meeting us at school, I hope that you are also very good at school and at home, both. And you are submitting the assignments that are supposed to be sent by you to the respective teachers. And I hope that I don't see you again for the rest of the days in the school, sitting in the punishment and doing your work. Please do not do that. Whatsoever the thing is, complete it. Be on time, be particular, be punctual, be regular. Okay, that is a sign of a good student. And I want you to be good students. Alright? So, children, as we know that from 18th of January, most expected date, it is to start with our preliminary examinations. Alright, so both 9th and 10th class will be having their examinations from that expected date. The official circulars, the official notice will be given to you soon. Till then, I want you to go through all the chapters, all the topics, all the syllabus that has been told to you, that has been given to you, and whatsoever the topics have been done till late, go through all those topics. I am not talking about only my subject, I am talking about all the other subjects, starting from English, Hindi, Maths, every subject. Alright? And I want you to do your best in these examinations, because these are going to tell you where you actually stand. Okay, it is going to tell 10th thesis, it is going to tell that where you will stand and what you will do in your 11th class, and for the 9th people, it is going to show you the mirror that what you are going to score in your 10th boards. Okay, so keep the next class into your consideration, keep the next session into your brains and work according to that. Alright, till then, let's continue with our topic that we have left in the previous few video, and we'll continue that same in this video. Okay, so come on, let's get started. This, okay, there might be few topics from between if left, otherwise we have almost completed our syllabus. So from my side, most of the topics that are important have been covered. Few things if left, we'll cover it in the revision section. Otherwise, from my side, most of the topic, like almost 90% of the topics are covered. There was just one thing which was, I think, like I was thinking of discussing with you people, and that is duties of a consumer. Like sometimes it is asked, apart from the rights of the consumer, it can be asked that what are the duties of a consumer. So as a consumer, you should know that what your duties are, not only for grabbing marks in the examination, but also becoming a rational and aware citizen of a country. So you should know what your duties as a consumer are. First is to check the maximum retail price of the product. A consumer must not pay price more than MRP. MRP is for 15 rupees. But you are paying 20 rupees, because people say that we have, like, if supposedly when you visit hilly areas, when you visit hill stations, so over there what they do is that they charge extra 5 rupees or extra 10 rupees for electricity charges, that we have kept this cold drink in the fridge and therefore 5 rupees extra for the chilled one, and MRP on MRP you will get the normal one. Okay, that is not acceptable. Though we pay prices, though we do accept that 5 rupees charge as electricity charge, but that is not acceptable. Alright, so, but it doesn't mean that you will go and you will start fighting with those people. It's okay. Like, it's not okay, but still it's okay if you are paying 5 rupees to those people, because yes, they do work harder than the plains one. Okay, still no comparisons and no debates on this topic. So to check the maximum retail price of the product. A consumer must not pay price more than the MRP. Then second is to check the date of expiry of the product. It is your fault if you haven't checked the expiry date. It is not the fault of the seller. It is the fault of the purchaser. It is the fault of the consumer who hasn't checked the expiry date and has purchased that particular product after expiry date. Like after the product has been expired, if you have purchased it, it is your fault. It is not the fault of the seller. To check that the seal is not broken, nor is the package torn. To check a proper bill of the purchase, it is very important that you take bill of the purchase. BOP, bill of the purchase, means that you take bill. You take invoice from them that yes, you have sold this commodity and I have purchased this commodity from you, which we people generally don't do. We don't ask for bills, we don't ask for receipts, we don't ask for invoice. Then fifth is, if the product is found defective or non-performing, then to take up the matter first with the manufacturer and then with the courts if not resolved by the manufacturer. Okay, but it doesn't mean that you will go to the court. It is better that you be aware, you be an aware citizen, an aware consumer. Then we have is food adulteration. I think we have done this topic in the earlier video. Now, food adulteration, you know what is food adulteration. Circumstances of food adulteration also, you know. And I think I have done this in the last video. Okay, let's just go through this fast. What is Eggmark and what is Ecomark? Now, Eggmark is, see, the term Eggmark was coined by joining the word A-G, egg, to mean agriculture, and mark for a certification mark, which means that it was introduced originally in the bill presented in the Parliament of India for the agricultural produce. Eggmark is a certification mark employed on agricultural products in India, assuring that they conform to set of standards approved by the Directorate of Marketing and Inspection, an agency of the Government of India. The Eggmark was legally enforced in India by the agricultural produce. Now, Eggmark is what? Eggmark is in mark. Trademark, or we say hallmark, which is given to the agricultural products that yes, they do meet up the standards which is set by the government, or which is set by the Directorate of Marketing and Inspection, or agricultural produce, or the government. Okay, so this is basically put on what the present Eggmark standards cover. Quality guidelines for 205 different commodities spanning a variety of pulses. Like Eggmark is put on what things? On pulses, cereals, not those cereals which you watch on the television, but cereals means that cereals which you eat in breakfast, essential oils, vegetable oils, fruits and vegetables, and semi-processed products like vermicellis. Okay. Then we have is Ecomark. What is Ecomark? Now, Ecomark scheme is administered by the Bureau of Indian Standard, BIS. Under this scheme, BIS, that is Bureau of Indian Standards, grants license to environment friendly products under a special scheme and award the Ecomark to such products, but these products should conform to additional requirements specified in the Indian standards to qualify. So far, the following products categories have been identified for coverage under this scheme, that is soap. Like Ecomark is put on what things comes under Ecomark: soap and detergents, paints, paper, plastic, cosmetics, textiles, batteries, wood substitute, prop plants and aerosols, food items,
इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक गुड्स, पैकिंग और पैकेजिंग मटेरियल, लुब्रिकेटिंग स्पेसिफाइड ऑयल्स, ड्रग्स, फूड, ड्रग्स मीन्स मेडिसिन, फूड्स, प्रिजर्वेटिव एंड एडिटिव, पेस्टिसाइड्स, लेदर्स एक्सेट्रा. इन एग्जामिनेशन इट कैन बी आस्क्ड दैट लिस्ट एनी फाइव आइटम्स और लिस्ट एनी फाइव प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर कैटेगराइज्ड और आइडेंटिफाइड अंडर इको मार्क. और इट कैन बी ऑल्सो गिवन दैट टू फोर आइटम्स कैन बी गिवन एंड इट कैन बी आस्क्ड दैट टिक द आइटम्स दैट आर कवर्ड अंडर द इको मार्क. सो यू शुड नो दैट वट कम्स अंडर एग मार्क एंड वट कम्स अंडर इको मार्क एंड ऑल्सो what are it their definitions. Okay, now finally with these two topics we finish with our top chapter. All right, now coming back to the contents, productive mechanism is important, land labor, efficiency of labor, capital and capital formation, entrepreneur, theory of demand, elasticity of demand, theory of supply, elasticity of supply, money we have done, banking, commercial and central we have done. Okay, I think market is left. Okay, market is left. So in market what we will do is in the next video, like whenever we'll start with our videos now, because this is going to be the last, I think this is going to be the last video of economics. So whenever we'll start with our videos, we'll start with the revision and we will cover, we will start with the topics that are untouched or which needs a little more brushing up. Okay. Otherwise, all the important topics, keeping the board syllabus into consideration, have been covered. All right. Any problem you have, you just contact to me. You just be in contact, be in touch with me through the mails that we have, because that is the only mode of communication that we share right now. All right. And whatsoever problem you have, you just don't hesitate to come up to your teachers and get them solved. All right, till then, take care. Bye-bye.